Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today's video, we're talking about Astro alternatives. I feel really sorry for everyone that has a third-party email app right now. The email space is not doing very well. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So today's video, I wanted to chat with you guys about Astro. I wanted to share a few alternatives as well, because as many of you know, Slack has now bought Astro and they are acquiring them and killing them off by the October the 10th, which is mad. Very fast email shutdown. And of course, this month we will be saying goodbye to the likes of Newton 2 and an announcement for March 2019, Google Inbox is going as well. This is really sad news and obviously definitely sucks for everyone who is committing to a third-party email app. They sort of feel a bit vulnerable. Guys, in today's video, I wanted to chat about the Astro alternatives that you might find useful. So guys, today's video is sponsored by Hive. I wanted to thank them and apologize as well because we were gonna put out a video last week. I had it all prepared. Windows and Android alternatives to Newton, it was gonna be beautiful. And the majority of the focus was on Astro. And then of course the news hit. So I do apologize for the delay on that video, but a big thank you to Hive for sponsoring today's video. Here's a little bit more information about them. So our kind sponsor of this week is Hive. Hive is an up and coming project management software, and they've been a sponsor here before on the channel, back when I did the remote work series, and it's great to have them back again. For those who don't know, Hive provides teams with a flexible way to connect over projects, interact with data, and get more things done. Multiple project views is probably one of Hive's killer features. Teams can use Kanban, Calendar, Gantt, and so many more views to outline goals and stay on task. Hive Analytics is another powerful feature too, using machine learning to create dashboards of actionable insights for teams' productivity. Hive also brings together grade A tools for your teams to get things done. The likes of a personal action list, forms and action templates, time tracking, integration with popular apps, file sharing, action cards, and tons more. Even a resource management tool added very, very recently. The kind team at Hive have passed on a 25% discount off your first 12 months on Hive. Just use Keep Productive as the coupon code and claim that one today. Don't fret, guys, if you're interested in learning more about Hive in a tutorial, I have added a tutorial below, which is available through YouTube, and you can watch that one there. So thanks again to Hive for sponsoring the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So guys, Astro alternatives, there are plenty out there on the market. I want to touch on Android first, a little bit on iOS, and a few more alternatives that might find useful for you. So one thing I would say about Astro is it was one of the best Android alternatives. There's not too many on that store that particularly do well. And of course, an application that spanned across iOS, Android, and Mac definitely looked more attractive. And I can definitely see why Slack bought it out. So for those Androiders out there, I do have a few recommendations for some alternatives. The first one, and one that is very similar to Astro, is Edison. Edison is an email application that spans across iOS and Android, and it does work very smoothly. It's got great Google Play ratings, and it also combines the assistant inside of Edison that would allow you to interact with your email in a bit of a smarter fashion. Now, inside of Edison, you do have smart filtering, so you can organize all of your emails, and it does make for a healthy mobile first solution if you guys are looking for both an iOS and Android alternative in case for future. Now next up is Blue Mail. Although I don't particularly recommend it as it's not in the most gorgeous design out there, it seems to have worked well and have built a brilliant user base on Android. Now it does look very similar to the alternative one, which is Type Mail. So do be aware just before that you check their name on the actual download. Blue Mail is free, although it does have a paid edition, I believe, which gives you access to a little bit more. Remember guys, I've done a full Newton alternatives video, which will apply to Astro alternatives, so you guys can go into a bit more detail there. Next up is definitely Microsoft Outlook. It is stunning, and especially with the web redesigns in the last couple of weeks and their plans in 2019 to add a Mac and desktop version for Windows, it does make it a lot more attractive, and the mobile applications work so well. Remember, this is the company that bought Sunrise just to install it inside of Microsoft Outlook, so you're gonna get a beautiful calendar experience when you are using it. Next up is Proton Mail. I see a lot of people email me, particularly using Proton Mail. Apparently, it is a very intuitive service, and the thing that they focus on a lot more is security. They have the best high-grade security and are run by a Swiss company, so you pretty much know that the security is going to be pretty high. Now, moving on to some iOS alternatives, of course, Astro was available on iOS, which is very sad to see. One of my top recommendations is Spark. I'm currently using it as my email application. I will be trialing Superhuman, which is it's coming very soon. It is a $30 per month email application, but I do want to review it and give it a full exploration before I commit to it, so do stay tuned for that. Things I specifically like about Spark as a user is the send later function. The UI works really well, and it tends to work really well on like iOS when you're syncing it. Of course, it doesn't have an Android app, but they are working on it, apparently. Of course, I mentioned Outlook. Outlook is fantastic on iOS 2, very similar to the Android version, but definitely worth checking out. You've also got Polymail on iOS, which seems to work very well. Again, this is a paid experience, so you're gonna have to really pay for this one if you're looking to unlock all of the team functionality. Again, it's more of a team function, but once you get into it, you can use some of the templating functions and to email out campaigns and plan in, schedule emails, track emails, do all the sort of advanced stuff that you'd expect with an email client of that magnitude. And another iOS solution that there's really pushed past a lot of the time is Airmail. Airmail is really well designed. It's a really gorgeous application for Mac and iOS, and it's definitely worth considering. The great thing about Airmail is it's a one-off fee, so you're not necessarily paying a subscription rate as you go. And finally, I would say Missive as well is a great option. This is something that Z Kane, and I did a video on this too, to thank him and also to recommend it to. It's actually pretty decent. It's available on Mac, Windows, Android, and iOS. It looks great. It has a free option that's very limiting to 15 days of history. But if you're willing to pay for an email application, this might be a great option for you. I'll include that video below. So guys, of course, it's hard to give advice on email apps at the moment because you don't know which one's going to shut down, which one's going to come out. Obviously, my sort of best advice would be try to look at the third-party paid alternatives, because obviously that is going to be something that they're going to be investing in and developing, and you know that the money is going to be supported there, of course, as a secure option. But again, you can't necessarily go by that rule, because Loon was a paid alternative at $49.99 a year, and we still had issues trying to grow and expand in the market. So guys, feel free to watch the full Newton Alternatives video. There's also an article on the Keep Productive YouTube channel, so you can go into full detail there. It's definitely worth checking out Hive in the description below. I've done a full tutorial on it on YouTube, so if you just want to jump to that one, you can do so too. Anyway guys, thanks for stopping by today. Hope you enjoyed it. Give it a like if you enjoyed it. Hit subscribe if you're brand new, and comment with any thoughts that you have on Astro. Anyway guys, thanks very much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.